When most people hear the term shield volcano, they think of a broad and gentle slope volcano often covered with fresh black lava in either the Hawaiian island chain or the Galapagos Islands. Yet, despite typically being associated with very faraway places, it might surprise people that the state of Oregon also contains not only a shield volcano, but one which is considered still active. The shield volcano I'm referring to can be found 30 miles west-northwest of the city of Bend, and already from satellite you can see a near-perfect circular region spanning 6.2 miles wide, which is covered in fresh-looking lava flows. This represents the Belknap Crater shield volcano, which completely formed in the last 10,000 years. If you were to have only been in this very spot 1,500 years ago, you would have witnessed spectacular lava fountains emanating from its summit cinder cone, which slowly but surely created a bright orange glow as it flowed downhill to the south. While Belknap Crater might be thought of as a fluke or rarity of sorts in the region, this is not the case. The Oregon portion of the Cascade Range has produced at least four Belknap Crater-like shield volcanoes in the last 500,000 years, of which Belknap Crater just happens to be the most recent. Yet, while Belknap Crater is the singular volcano, it challenges the notion of being a typical shield volcano, as while many famous shield volcanoes erupt from the same central vent multiple times, Belknap Crater never did this. Instead, Belknap Crater could best be thought of as the combination of several distant, moderately explosive to effusive eruptions, which, when combined, formed a shield-like structure. Its central cone might look truly uniform at first, but in reality is the combination of two separate small-scale shield volcanoes in addition to two small flank vents. In other words, no vent erupts twice at this volcano, and Belknap as a whole is considered monogenetic. The first eruption of Belknap Crater occurred 4 miles northwest of its modern summit. As Low Silica basaltic magma intruded into the crust approximately 9,500 years ago, it generated a series of earthquakes. Soon, persistent rumbling became audible until finally the expansion of gases propelled the magma upwards, causing it to break through the southwestern slope of the extinct Mount Washington shield volcano and erupt via a 500-foot-tall fountain of lava. Within a few minutes, an underlying dike of magma also reached the surface in 6 additional locations to the south, meaning lava was now erupting along a 9,500-foot-long stretch of land. Intermittent explosions subsequently began, which created ash, and these combined with falling bombs of lava to create a series of cinder cones. As lava erupted at a high rate, numerous lobes of lava created sounds similar to glass breaking and advanced at a slow speed of up to 50 feet an hour towards the west. By the time this 3.5-week-long eruption ended, approximately 4 square miles had been covered in lava via what are today called the inaccessible cones. The next eruption from this complex occurred around 5050 BCE, but this time did not have a mildly explosive component to it. Shorter fountains of lava were still generated, but instead a short spatter cone breach towards the west was constructed, which fed the Tamalich lava flow that would travel 4.5 miles to the southwest. Before the next eruption, the magma chamber of Belknap Crater underwent fractional crystallization, causing its magma composition to change from basalt to basaltic andesite. A nearly 2-decade-long eruption followed in 900 BCE, where a central vent overflowed its pit crater and sent lava flows in all directions at a rate of about 7 cubic meters per second. This eruption would have been spectacular to watch and formed the Little Belknap Shield Volcano. The next eruption occurred around the year zero, creating a 1 square mile lava flow on Belknap's southern flank. 300 years later, a moderately explosive eruption occurred at 2 simultaneous vents where the twin craters and South Belknap cinder cones erupted for a period of several months. Belknap's last eruption happened to be its largest where, for a period of several decades, a moderately explosive eruption built a central cinder cone which effused layer after layer of basaltic andesite lava primarily towards the west. By the eruption's end, a peak now stood 2,000 feet higher than what used to be much lower topography in the same spot only 10,000 years prior. Today, it is assumed that Belknap Crater as a shield volcano will never erupt again since its vents are monogenetic. However, there is still a low probability potential for new vents to one day pop up within an up to 7-mile radius of this fascinating shield volcano. Such future eruptions will be most likely completely effusive to moderately explosive, albeit remote, with the potential to disrupt regional air traffic, or have lava potentially flow onto Route 126 or Route 242. As a result of these hazards, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Belknap Crater as a low-threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.